Day one of the lockdown, and one could not help but notice that the only shop that was open on the entire length of the Champs-Élysées in Paris was a chocolate shop.
कोरोना व्हायरसचा संसर्ग रोखण्यासाठी जगभरातील अनेक देशांमध्ये लॉकडाऊन असलं तरी अत्यावश्यक सेवा सुरू आहेत. पण अत्यावश्यक म्हणजे काय यावर प्रत्येक देशाचं मत वेगळं आहे.
All the boulangerie and fromagerie, cheese shops, butchers and wine merchants and indeed chocolatier that still exist and which give France still so much of its character. All these shops have been given exemptions and can stay open, and the French, I have to say, are all mighty glad of the fact.
In the US, what counts as an essential service depends on where you live, and states have made controversial choices, like gun stores. After the Trump administration released guidance supporting classifying gun shops as essential, states have allowed firearm businesses to remain open, and sales have surged to record levels. Marijuana dispensaries, both medical and recreational, have also been allowed to remain open in the states where they're legal, like Colorado, though they have adopted new social distancing measures like curbside pickup.
For the past few weeks, all restaurants, bars, clubs, and pubs have been closed here in Australia. But off-licenses or liquor stores, they remain open, so you can go buy a drink, but you'll have to have it at home. Toy shops are an interesting gray area. Some are closed and others are open to a limited number of customers at any given time. And I know what you're thinking, why are toys crucial? Well, the Prime Minister Scott Morrison did say himself that his wife had to go and buy their children a whole bunch of jigsaw puzzles because they were essential for his family as they changed the way they live in the next few months.
काही देशांमध्ये निर्बंधांमुळे ज्यावर बंदी आहे त्यावर लोकांची नाराजी उफाळून आली आहे.
Most people who know a bit about the Philippines are aware of the iconic jeepney bus, but there is another form of essential transport here called the tricycle. They're a bit like Batman and Robin's Batbike, but last month, strict quarantine measures placed on the country's main island, Luzon, meant all public transport was banned. However, a popular young local mayor in Manila, Vico Soto, allowed trikes to be used by medical workers. But the next day, Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte warned local officials not to break quarantine rules. But now, President Duterte's daughter Sara, mayor of Davao City, has also allowed trikes to be used. Her exemption being that the city doesn't fall under Luzon quarantine measures. Who would have thought the humble tricycle could be so political?
For the first time in the history of India, its extensive railway network, considered lifeline for the country, has been halted. But halting these trains that carry more than 23 million passengers every day has had a fallout. Lots of daily wage earners have been stranded in the cities without money, food or shelter. The government's now making arrangements for them. Interestingly, the information technology sector has been exempted from what is otherwise a stringent shutdown, with a view to keep networks that are crucial to communication, banking and governance running.